Jesus explains homosexuality and faith of Tel Aviv and New York City, and let your light shine. April 13th, 2016. Words from Jesus to Sister Claire, spoken by Jackie. May the presence of the Lord bring you great comfort and endurance this day, heart dwellers. I spent a great deal of time tonight, along with Ezekiel, in just keeping our Lord company, feeling the heaviness and pain in his heart over the unsaved in this late hour. I came into worship. At first, I could not see his face clearly and struggled for a few moments, even questioning if I had done something to displease him. And I just got this impulse to ask him to show me his face clearly. Well, immediately he did. It was so clear, I wanted to stop what I was doing and drawing. So I began our time together by thanking him for this grace. Thank you, Lord, for making your sweet face so clear to me. All you had to do was ask. Why didn't I think of that before? I don't know. A little bird must have told you. And why didn't the little bird tell me? You ask too many questions. I know, guilty as charged. He began to speak. I want everyone who is carrying their cross and laboring to know that the end is in sight. They need to know this, Claire. The journey has been long and extended many times. But now we are nearing that window of time when it must be accomplished. The Azusa Prayer Rally has made its mark on the heart of the Father. How very edified he is to see this response in his people. They shall not go without their reward. And what he's referring to here is, one of our listeners had asked, won't this make an effect, this prayer rally? I think it was going on in two different parts of the country. Won't this have an effect on the tribulation or on the judgment? And so that was in the back of my mind when he said that. And I hadn't gone looking at the news or anything to know anything about this prayer rally. It was just brought right before me. So he answered me and said, you see, you do not have to go looking. I bring things before you. And I thought, wow, I hope she's listening. By the way, heart dwellers, if you want a question answered, please don't ask me. Ask Jesus to answer it for you, and he will. He'll bring it up. Even as was told to the child Nathan, everything could be softened by the repentance and prayers of the people. That is exactly what has happened. And there are others around the world who have responded in like kind. All in all, the judgments are being softened. Yet there are still places that are slated for destruction. New York is one of them, Tel Aviv another. There are no cries of repentance coming from these cities. In fact, their lewdness continues to grow and assert itself in the world. Shall I not put an end to these places? Lest Sodom and Gomorrah cry out for justice. Yet I love these souls dearly and see the crooked ways they have been formed in. what he's talking about here is Tel Aviv is the world capital for homosexuals. So that's why he's pinpointing Tel Aviv, and New York is probably a close second. I love these souls dearly, and see the crooked ways they have been formed in. Some from childhood, others from choice. And there is a genetic code that makes one more sensitive to this aberration. But never was it intended to be expressed in same-sex relationships. They are an abomination to me. Rather, some are more disposed to celibacy, and with that calling have a very specific grace to be detached from sexual involvements for the greater good of mankind. But the enemy has inserted his reasoning, drawing them into sin, justifying that decision. There are many who would argue this point with you, but I'm giving it to you straight. There is oftentimes a genetic reality underlying this leaning. It is no different than a normal person committing adultery or fornication with the opposite sex. Morality is a decision that must be made and lived by, and much homosexuality is demonically provoked and inspired. Oh Lord, this is such a sad and dark subject for me. I've seen so many torn apart by this lifestyle. Is the logic and the demons that conspire to draw a soul into this sin, and the sins of men against women and women against men, Satan has so cleverly manipulated. And I must say that same-sex relationships can be equally, if not more, in conflict and dysfunctional. That is not the answer to a happy marriage. It is by my will and my choice that a holy relationship is formed. I alone know the path a man and woman must travel in this life. I alone know what they will pursue and not pursue. And if they do not know me and seek me to bring them the right mate, well, divorce or unhappiness is ultimately the fate of those who do not seek me in their choice of marriage partner. I will say that arranged marriages have greater staying power, even though they are not ideal. Because the culture has firm boundaries they are held to. This is expected to be a contract between two adults that is the fabric of the culture, so divorce is seriously discouraged. I'm not saying they are happy lives, but they are more free from the frivolity of emotions. I want to return to the events at hand. I know these crosses you have carried for months now, my brides, have grown weighty, and I also know how they have paved the way for the salvation of many that had no chance. I also see the tremendous growth in you, who have willingly taken on Simon's cross on my behalf. You do not see it, but so much progress in holiness and brotherly love has been made in your lives, and your reward continues to grow, although I know that is the last thing on your minds. But I'm here to tell you that we are nearing the end, and every prayer and act of repentance on behalf of sins committed is making an impact and changing the intensity of the judgments in severity and scope. It is also playing a part in the lives of families who have intercessors. There will be extended mercy for their loved ones because they loved much and cared enough to pray for those they do not even know. They prayed because of the ache in my heart, and therefore I will move in sovereign ways to protect the ache in their hearts, the destiny of their loved ones. So continue to grow in stature, my brides, you are growing into the realms of my love, into the depth and width and breadth of my love for mankind. You're becoming more like me every day, and when I snatch you up from this sinful mire, you will barely recognize yourselves, so steeped in glory will you be. Carry on, my dear ones. You are changing the course of history with your prayers. Carry on. I bless you now with my peace and inward joy to calm your fears and stabilize you in the events yet to come. Let that joyful light, the joy of my countenance, shine out from within your hearts. You are the light of the world.